Earlier today, we was having breakfast, sausage, bacon, all that. Not early morning, not like 6 o'clock. We had about 11 o'clock.
Yeah. We didn't have any beans.
Yeah, we ran out of beans. We had the op. Garden Gold. Really nice. And now this is their cider.
Their cider version. So
yeah. It's made from 100% bittersweet apples. It's a refreshingly cloudy English cider. 5%. Now, anytime I see that, I just remember the artwork is just really, really good.
So what, you got the apple there, and the hog representing the...
Yeah, I'm guessing the reason why, I mean, if you look on their website, they mostly produce beers. Mm. I'm guessing because there's a hog in their theme, they thought compulsed to make a cider, because yeah, cider and pig are almost like the perfect marriage, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, because whatever you have pork, you know what I mean? You have apple,
yeah.
And also, if
back in the days of Robin Hood, they used to put apple in of a pig.
Yeah.
It reminds me of the... What's it called? The Farm or something? You know, that film where all the animals turn... Rivet?
Animal Farm?
Animal Farm, yeah. Whenever I see this at this brewery, I was thinking that. No explosion.
Where they all rebel against the farmers or something.
I don't know if this is a... Well, it does say it as apples, but sometimes some ciders do say that, and we've drank them, and it's like, no. Well, let's look. But the artwork is really nice. I am a fan of the artwork. I mean, I visited the... I was looking up the information on this morning. Wow.
It's a lovely, crisp...
It's orangey colour. Now, considering it says cloudy, I'm not getting cloudy.
It's sort of bronze, isn't it? It's almost.
It has a slight haze, but I think that's just due to cold.
Hang on a minute. Old Crack Brewery has crafted the traditional cider with friends followed from the family business. Thatchers. The leading cider mix in Somerset.
Oh, okay, so they've teamed up with Thatchers for this. That's pretty cool. I mean, we just had the Prince William from Thatchers, and that was real nice.
As it's like, with the help of the Thatchers. I mean,
it's good that they actually turned to a good local cider place, well, rather than, let's turn to Frosty Jack. Let's turn to White Lightning. To brew the cider. No, we've turned to Thatchers, which...
Yeah.
If you mention Thatchers to anyone, they'll go, good cider.
Mm.
But, in all fairness, it's a really wrong colour for that, for a cider. But...
Well, it's...
It reminds me of a bitter we had. It gave off the apple aroma, it gave off that... almost sour approach. It gives that...
There's a sweetness on the aroma, sort of quite mild. There's a bit of flavour there, but then it just disappears. There's not much to it.
It's weird. You're almost getting the taste of a badly made golden ale.
Yeah.
You know, we've had it before with some beers. We've had a beer that tastes of cider apple. We've had beers that taste of apple. And we've had...
It does almost taste like an ale.
Yeah.
But
we've had bitters that tasted like sours. I mean, from down south. And we thought, now if this were a... Last week, didn't we as well? If this were a lambic or a sour, it'd be a really nice beer. But of course, it's not. It's going down the sink. But in all fairness, this is supposed to be cider, so...
It's a bit bland, not much to it really, and bit wishy-washy. Almost. Not great.
Yeah, I mean, considering we've had a Hogs back beer today, and we've had a... And that was really nice. And we've had a Thatchers Cider that was really nice. This collaboration hasn't worked for me.
No.
No. It's a bit...
I mean, it says here as well, it's a refreshing cloud English cider. Oh, that's... Is that cloudy?
No.
Would you say that's cloudy?
No. There's the bottle. I think we put... What did you bought this, didn't you?
Yeah. I think I just put it in boots or something.
Don't drink all of it, just...
I'm almost getting a bit of a sweet apple now.
Right. Now it's had a proper shake.
Now it's...
That's lift. Is it
sort of cloudy now?
I suppose it... Yeah. Again. I mean, Western's... Western's make one called the Old Rosie. That's what you're doing.
Yeah, you can see it at the bottom.
It's in there.
There's a lot of yeast in the bottom.
Oh, you test that, I'll keep it shaking.
That's a bit better. You see it?
Yeah.
It's sort of settled at the bottom.
Yeah, it's all gone now. It's a little more, actually, look. You see the discoloration there? It's a little bit more. I mean, before it was just like, boom. Now it's like...
That's cloudy, that.
It's giving off more apple now. But yeah, it has been sat in for a while, hasn't it? I don't know if you'd be able to use this.
It is quite, sort of settled now. It's not as perfumey.
Mm. You can definitely get those Thatcher traits down.
Mm.
But it's still giving off that ale feel.
Mm.
In fairness, it's a lot better now than it was when we started drinking it.
Mm, yeah.
What about again? If the price is right, yes.
Yeah.
But if I saw a better cider for the same price, I'd buy that. But I applaud their efforts.
Yeah.
I mean, they've gone to the trouble of actually making a cider and actually choosing wisely and going with a real proper cider company like Thatchers.
Yeah.
So, praise to that. But there you go. That's a chance. For the artwork. And the collaboration, I praise. There you go, there's the website there. But yeah, I do suggest people try more ciders. I mean, Andrew's getting more and more into ciders now. Last year we purchased so many ciders, we're still trying to get through them all.
The Winnell ciders.
Yeah, the Winnell ciders, the Norfolk ciders, and Guap King and Gwentrey and...
I mean, the year before as well, I was drinking a lot of Somerset ciders.
Yeah.
Like Sheppies and that were...
Yeah, Sheppies and Gamers and such. But definitely try more ciders, which is the message. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.